It can be seen creeping along roadways and crowding out fields across Ethiopia. Sign your land away. That's what some farmers in this African country call the devastatingly invasive weed, because once it appears, they might as well give up. Its scientific name is Parthenium hysterophorus, an alien weed from Central America. The voracious white-flowered invader reduces crop yield, takes over pastures, and taints the taste of cows' milk and meat. It impinges on biodiversity and causes many health problems, including asthma, bronchitis, hay fever, and skin rashes. Million Abebe, an entomologist in Ethiopia, says the damage from the weed is widespread.
Parthenium has spread to almost every corner of the country now.
But he and other researchers are developing ways to combat it. The Integrated Pest Management Innovation Lab, a program funded by USAID and managed by Virginia Tech, works to promote methods that reduce the damage caused by pests without harming the environment. It has a collaborative project in Ethiopia led by Virginia State University that has been working to fight Parthenium. In the central Ethiopian town of Ambo, the program established the country's first official quarantine facility and weed biological control program. Muni Muniapen, director of the IPM Innovation Lab at Virginia Tech, donned a special white jumpsuit to enter the quarantine facility. Inside, researchers are breeding and testing insects that feed on the Parthenium. Sintu Elameu is an entomologist at the Ambo facility. She received training supported by the IPM Innovation Lab on how other countries were fighting Parthenium. Even with the protective clothing, she says, the weed can be difficult to handle.
When I start working with Parthenium at the first, I got skin allergy. Then after 1 year, I developed respiratory allergy too.
Elsewhere in Ethiopia, near the city of Adama, the weed-eating beetles are being raised in special outdoor tents.
Put them on new plant. We cut this one, right?
Yeah.
Here.
Researchers are planning a controlled release of the insects this summer. That coincides with a four-day workshop sponsored by the IPM Innovation Lab that will bring together scientists from around the world to share information about the weed and try to slow its spread to other countries. For more information on the workshop, or the IPM Innovation Lab's work in Ethiopia, go to www.oired.vt.edu. For Outreach and International Affairs, this is Rich Matheson reporting.